Well, these days, a lot of the timber that we use is treated to extend its versatility and its life. The chemicals used to preserve wood are designed to be toxic to pests. Some can harm people or the environment if not handled properly. So it's important to select the right timber for the job and to always choose the least toxic alternative. People can be exposed to the chemicals in treated timber at home or at work through sawdust or vapours produced by cutting tools, or by coming into contact with smoke or ash after treated timber has been burned. Now, risks are also present if you have contact with soil, where treated timber wood chips or sawdust have been used as mulch. Now, some timber is treated with copper chrome arsenate, CCA, which contains arsenic, a chemical that can cause cancer in humans. Now, because of the concerns that arsenic could be absorbed through the skin or swallowed, CCA treated timber is no longer used for high contact surfaces such as garden furniture, picnic tables, exterior seating, play equipment, handrails, and patio and domestic decking. There are a number of different chemicals used to treat timber. To help with choosing which type is suitable for a particular job, a system of 6 hazard classes has been established, depending on what organisms the timber may be exposed to and what environment it will be in. Labels on the timber describe which hazard class the timber is suitable for. Now remember, some timber treatments are potentially harmful to humans, so it's important to choose the least toxic suitable alternative. You can also consider using alternatives to treated timber, such as hardwoods that have natural biological resistance, or plastic, aluminium, or composite wood look products. Timber treated with boron-based products is resistant to borers and some kinds of termites. These timbers need to be kept dry and above ground to protect the treatment from leaching out. Timber treated with synthetic pyrethroids is suitable for interior framing and structural beams. LOSP is short for light organic solvent preservative. LOSP-treated timbers are also good structural timbers resistant to fungi, termites and borers, but can't be used in the ground where they come into contact with water. Copper-based alternatives to CCA include copper azole, sometimes abbreviated to CA, and alkaline copper quaternary, known as ACQ. They are resistant to borers and termites and can be placed in the ground outside. Copper chrome arsenate, known as CCA, is timber treated with a mixture of copper, chromium, and arsenic. CCA has been used to treat timber since the 1930s. The copper in CCA inhibits fungi, while the arsenic kills insects. The chromium binds the other two chemicals to the wood. If not handled correctly, CCA treated timber can be hazardous because it contains arsenic. The chemicals in CCA-treated timber may be ingested or inhaled as sawdust when working with the product or as vapours when using power tools. If CCA-treated timber is burnt, high concentrations of arsenic may be present in the smoke and ash. There is also concern about CCA-treated timber as a touch hazard. This is why it's not to be used for high contact surfaces. Now, it's commonly believed that all green-tinged timber is CCA, but other forms of treated timber which do not contain arsenic may also appear green. CCA should be labelled with the words treated with copper chrome arsenate. As the labels, brands and stains on treated timber may be removed or fade with time, identification can be difficult. So if you're unsure what a structure is made from, you should handle it as if it is CCA. CCA can be used for fences, retaining walls, jetty piles and building poles, but not for garden furniture, picnic tables, exterior seating, patio and domestic decking, and handrails. You should protect yourself and those around you from potential hazards when working with treated timber. You should use appropriate personal protective equipment. Always wear gloves when handling or working with treated timber. Wear protective eyewear to keep dust and vapours away from your eyes. Wear a mask to avoid breathing in dust and fumes. P1, P2 or N95 masks are recommended. Work outside if possible, or use a dust extraction device to avoid inhaling sawdust or vapours. You should clean up any residue sawdust and any other waste as you go and not allow it to accumulate. Once the job is finished, wash your hands and face thoroughly before eating, drinking, or going to the toilet, or smoking. Once the job's been completed, treated timber should not be ignored. This goes for existing structures too. Don't forget, if you can't positively identify that an existing timber structure isn't CCA, treat it as if it is. If concerned about children coming into contact with treated timber, paint it with a polyurethane or oil-based paint. Avoid putting food in direct contact with treated timber, and wash the kids' hands if they've been touching treated timber surfaces, particularly before eating. Finally, do not allow water runoff from treated timber to be used as drinking water, especially CCA. Because of the chemicals in treated timber, waste must be managed with care. Small amounts of treated timber can be put in the regular rubbish bin, but not in your green waste bin if you have a separate one. And treated timber should never be recycled. Larger amounts of waste should be taken to a landfill site. Treated timber should never be used to build animal housing. And the sawdust or chips shouldn't be used for mulch, compost, or animal bedding. Treated timber, especially CCA, should never be burned, whether in stoves, fireplaces, confined spaces, or used to cook food. Burning treated timber releases toxic chemicals, and you should not leave treated timber where others may take it and use it for firewood. Ash from CCA, including after bushfires, is toxic and may contain more than 10% of its weight as heavy metal residue. Wear PPE to clean it up, double bag it, and take it to a landfill site. Don't attempt to bury it yourself. Breathing CCA smoke or contact with ash are two of the most common ways of being exposed to arsenic. Symptoms of overexposure to arsenic include nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and pins and needles. Anyone who thinks they may have been poisoned should seek medical advice. So, what are the key points you should remember about treated timber? Firstly, choose the right treated timber for the job and always select the least toxic suitable alternative. Secondly, wear appropriate PPE and make sure you clean up after working with treated timber, and then wash your face and hands thoroughly. Always dispose of treated timber in the correct way. And remember, treated timber can't be recycled or burnt. You should also manage finished or existing treated timber structures appropriately. That's all from me. Thanks for listening, and I hope you find this information useful.